Now, bring the arcade experience home, because your vision is our vision. ColecoVision.
Hey kids, Pete from Pivot Central here. For the last several weeks, I've been so taunted by comments and posts and images all over social media from all these people who have found the new AtGames flashbacks at their local Toys R Us and other places are being sold. AtGames has been known for the flashback series and the Atari Flashback, and actually last year I picked up an Atari Flashback 4 at my local grocery store. I've been looking all over for them, and a few weeks ago I asked at my local Toys R Us, I was like, hey, do you guys have these new flashbacks for Coleco and Intellivision? And they're like, you know, I think we may have had some, but I think they're all sold out. Really? Well, I think you have a computer, and maybe you could take a look at that, rather than guessing. That still got me nowhere. They had none, and they didn't know when any were coming in. So it's just kind of a hit or miss thing. So this past weekend, happened to be going by Toys R Us. Let's just stop in and see what they've got. And you know what? It was the motherlode. They had Atari Flashback 4s. They had the newer Flashback 5. And they also had the Sega Genesis. It's not really a flashback. They don't really call it that, but it's a little mini console. It actually has a cartridge slot. Well, they had that, and I picked that up last year at the grocery store along with my Atari Flashback 4, but they did have the Intellivision Flashback as well as a Coleco, and I didn't feel like buying both of them, so I picked up the Coleco one because I just always loved Coleco. Never had it when I was a kid, but that was one of the first consoles that I came across when I started collecting stuff. It was in the box full of Atari stuff. So a lot like the other flashbacks we've seen from Atari, this is much the same concept. It's a miniature replica of what the ColecoVision once looked like. And let's take a little peek inside and see what we got going on here. Whoa. Here we've got our instructions. We've got the console itself. And it's got the two controllers and your AC, and it's even got a couple of overlays. I think it comes with four overlays for some of the games. Okay, so the console itself is reminiscent of the ColecoVision, and it's got a power button and a reset switch on the front. Your AC is on the side, and that's pretty much there is to it. There's really nothing else. Got the RCA jacks, you get your audio and video ported out of the thing. And here are your joysticks, which are extremely reminiscent of the joysticks that came with the original ColecoVision. You have your side-mounted fire buttons on each side. And the joystick here, it's, you know, sort of a hybrid between, like, Intellivision really had more of a thumb pad, and this is sort of like a raised thumb pad, so it's sort of a bit of a pseudo-joystick versus thumb pad thing. But in any event, it's a little stiff feeling. I don't know. I'm not sold on how long this is going to last, necessarily. Now, another interesting thing they've done with this is they've included some overlays that they have for four different games. They have it for Fortune Builder, War Room, Blackjack and Poker, and Dam Busters. So much like any of these sort of things, they just slide into the side like that. And they leave a bit of a little more of a visual hint as to what some of the buttons are for, as opposed to just the plain numeric keypad. So for those games that require them, that's kind of helpful. I'm not, to be honest, not really familiar with those games and how necessary the overlays would be in terms of just, can I play the game without it or whatnot. So the console itself, very lightweight. I mean, it has like no heft to it whatsoever. You feel like it's going to just float off the table in a gust of wind. But the joysticks, they're a little bit heavier feeling. They don't have the same kind of lightweight feeling as the console does. But again, how long the buttons and the joystick mechanism will last, we'll just test the time. We'll have to see. So for the sake of comparison, we got out our original ColecoVision. We set it up here next to our flashback. And, you know, if you take a look, the flashback console and its controller, you know, are quite reminiscent of the ColecoVision itself, which, you know, it's kind of a neat, nice little tribute. But some people will complain about this and say, you know, well, you know, it's just a little, like, ROM box, and you're just playing ROMs. And whereas that's true, one of the neat things they did with the ColecoVision, which kind of they did on one, I forget which of the flashbacks, but one or two of the Atari flashbacks had some homebrew games on it, maybe one or two. The ColecoVision one here actually has 12 homebrew games, which really gives you a neat opportunity to check out some games that weren't sort of, you know, in general release at the time that the ColecoVision came out. So that's a pretty cool feature to it. And there are also some versions to it, depending on where you buy it. I don't know if there's any difference in the packaging, so it may be just the retailer, but Different versions, one retailer has an extra game on it, and I believe another one actually has additional overlays. So this the one that I got at Toys R Us came with the 4 overlays and the 60 games. So I don't know how many more, but I would guess maybe, you know, between 2 and 4 more. And the other thing that's really neat about this is whenever you hear the term flashback and it's referring to video games, people think Atari Flashback, because that really was been what AtGames had done. Then that Sega one came out, but now they're branching out, 2 in 1 year, both at the same time, the ColecoVision and the Intellivision one came out. So hopefully this will really bring a new resurgence to retro gaming, and particularly to the Coleco platform, which really was a pretty underrated console when it came out, and, you know, due to some of the timing, you know, the video game crash and so forth, it didn't really have a long lifespan. But it's really got some amazing games. So that's a quick look at the ColecoVision Flashback from AtGames. The thing I really like most about these is just the simplicity of playing a lot of games by just popping this on the TV and you're good to go. Always love to have the original equipment, but since we've had Atari Flashbacks and it's kind of fun to just whip those out and play some cool Atari games, it's really neat that it's kind of expanding out in 1 year to both ColecoVision and the Intellivision. So hopefully I'll get the Intellivision one at some point and check out some of those games, but this is a quick look at it, and I think it's pretty cool. Hopefully the price will come down a little bit. Right now it's about $40. You know, if you can wait a year, you can probably find this at your local supermarket. You never know. Keep it retro, have fun, and it must be Christmas time soon, because flashbacks only come out when the Christmas season is upon us. So and that grocery store of mine, they've already got Christmas stuff all over, and it's still about 80 degrees out, so, yep, we're heading into the Christmas season. Get a flashback, keep it retro, and have fun.
This is the arcade experience. We're ColecoVision. We bring the arcade experience home.